I was born into an Anglo-Italian family. You had no other choice. Everything we did revolved around food. From the moment you woke up, you were discussing what you were probably having for dinner the next day. I grew up eating probably two plates of pasta a day as a child. The first time I really sat up and thought about food, arancini on the back of a Caronte ferry going from Villa San Giovanni to Messina, age three. Probably because I was also terrified that the ship would sink, but I remember it very clearly. I went to university and did a master's in Italian food, the history, the culture of eating in the hospital as a palliative care. And it was while I was doing that when I started to kind of realise that I kind of was more passionate about cooking than I'd realised, and that it was such a big part of my life. When I was at university, I was actually diagnosed as being obese, and it's quite weird because I'd never seen myself in that light. It's actually really influenced how I cook and eat and the menus we put on at pop-ups and supper clubs. I ate everything I wanted, whenever I wanted, and I find the real satisfaction for me is anticipation. I always think that's the key to a great meal. For me, it's one of those dishes which has a lot of kind of history and meaning for me. We've done it the very traditional kind of nonna way. And we did carrots, celery, and onion. Really, really finely chopped, beyond brunoise, I think is the description I would probably use. Cooked that in the pan with a bit of Calabrian olive oil. In a separate pan, I had some wonderful mince which I got from the farm in Leicestershire. Browned it off completely. I think one mistake a lot of people make when they make a bolognese is putting it straight in with the vegetables, not browning it off. If you do that, you end up with something quite tough, quite chewy. You end up stewing the meat. So we cooked that for about half an hour on a kind of low, medium low heat. After that, skimmed off the fat, added a little bit of white wine, just gives it that flavour, that sweetness of the grape. Mixed that together with the sofrito and added just a tiny bit more white wine. We let it all evaporate before I used the triple concentrate tomato paste. I think a lot of people you see kind of tipping the cans of tomato in, but really the only tomato to really touch it should be the paste. Usually you'd put a bit of pancetta or prosciutto. I actually put some Italian sausage in it, just because the meat is very lean, but the sausage, Italian sausage, has this wonderful amount of fat in it. And everybody knows fat's good for morale. I made a tomato broth as well, a tomato and Parmesan stock. We had celery, onion, carrots. We had the Torpedino tomatoes, which are a wonderful hybrid tomato. And then what we do is we slowly introduce the broth to the meat. For the pasta, we used roughly about 300 grams of very finely milled semolina flour to 100 grams of 00 flour, and then all egg yolks. I would say roughly 15 egg yolks, no egg whites, just to make a very rich, typical pasta dough from Emilia Romana, which is where the dish originates. As you probably realise throughout this description, at no point we've added any cream, no milk, no dried herbs, no fresh herbs, nothing. This is the way it's kind of written down by Artusi in 1850. So it's the classic tagliatelle al ragu from Bologna. We cut the pasta into tagliatelle, made it quite a long pasta, and just finish it in the pan with a bit of the water, which has the starch in it, some more Parmigiano Reggiano, just to create a bit of an emulsion. And I put one spoon of the ragu in there. Top tips for this dish: use the best tomato paste you can use. We used a very good one, a triple concentrate. But the beef was fantastic, even when you're cooking it. I mean, it's when we go to such efforts with sourcing, you know, the right tomato paste or the Italian sausages, you have to make that effort with the beef. And for me, it's very much a testament. The way the dish turns out is a testament to the farmer, because the meat really does make it special. It's a wonderful quality. A very great Italian chef once told me that the food you like to eat is good food. So if you want to put garlic in it, if you want to put red wine in it, dried oregano, rosemary, cream, butter, if you like it that way, then do it that way. I personally think this is a restaurant quality dish.